हेलो एवरीवन, वंस अगेन वेलकम टू उदयनाथ ऑटोनॉमस कॉलेज ऑफ साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी वर्चुअल प्लेटफॉर्म एंड यू आर वाचिंग यूएन कॉलेज डिजिटल क्लास यूट्यूब चैनल। इन आवर प्रीवियस वीडियो लेक्चर्स वी हैड ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड एन न्यूट्रिशनल प्रॉब्लम। व्हाट इज न्यूट्रिशनल प्रॉब्लम, टाइप्स ऑफ न्यूट्रिशनल प्रॉब्लम, एंड देर इज टू टाइप्स ऑफ न्यूट्रिशनल प्रॉब्लम। वन इज अंडर न्यूट्रिशन एंड अनदर वन इज ओवर न्यूट्रिशन। एंड इन आवर प्रीवियस वीडियो लेक्चर्स वी हैड ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड what is undernutrition and what are the diseases or problems which are related with undernutrition nutritional problem. And now in this class we will discuss on what is overnutrition and what are the problems or diseases related with overnutritional problem. And in this class we will discuss about different diseases which are occurring due to overnutrition. First we will discuss on what is overnutrition. And overnutrition is occurs when an individual has an excessive consumption of food far more than their dietary needs. When a person is taking over food which is necessary for a person, and when a person is taking over diet or over a meal which is need or required for a person to avoid or to follow the balanced diet. And when a person is taking imbalanced diet, then the person is known as overnutrition. Overnutrition is defined as the overconsumption of nutrients and food to the point at which health is adversely affected. For maintaining a healthy life, we need nutrition. And in nutrition, we have to take nutrients which are required for our health. But there is different quantity of nutrients, of different types of nutrients is necessary for different category people. And we have to take the required nutrients which are necessary for maintain a healthy life. Then we can maintain a better life and beautiful life. And when a person is taking the wrong nutrients and the wrong quantity of nutrients, then the person will be coming under overnutrition. Overnutrition can develop into obesity, which increases the risk of serious health conditions, including cardiovascular diseases, hypertension, cancer, and type 2 diabetes. The prevalence of overweight and obesity is increasing in developing countries and even in low-income groups in richer countries. Problems of overnutrition are increasing even in countries where hunger is prevalent. Overnutrition also can develop different diseases, which are obesity, hypertension, cardiovascular diseases, cancer, type 2 diabetes. These are some diseases which are related with overnutrition. And obesity is also a major problem due to overnutrition. When a person is taking overnutrition, then the person will coming under overweight. So that the person is known as overnutrition. And due to overnutrition, the person will face different types of diseases, which is risk for a human life. And under overnutrition, first we will discuss about the disease that is bulimia. And bulimia is an eating disorder marked by cycles of binge eating of excessive quantities of food, followed by purging through vomiting or use of laxatives. A person with bulimia is rarely grossly underweight. Bulimia, also called bulimia nervosa, and tends to start in late childhood or early adulthood. Bulimia is a disease which is occurring due to eating the disorder. When a person is taking or eating different types of food, but from which food the person will not get the proper nutrients which are necessary for our health. And the bulimia is also known as bulimia nervosa. And it's a disorder which is occurred due to eating disorder or lack of nutrients in a human being. Sometimes some persons are taking food at that time when they will able or capable for vomiting, and this is for overnutrition or overtaking of different food, and so that the person will unhealthy and the person is facing different types of problems due to eating disorder. So that bulimia is occurring due to intaking of the lack of nutrients and disorder of nutrients. And in bulimia disease, some persons are also underweight because of different health issues. Next is signs and symptoms in bulimia disease. Being preoccupied with your body shape and weight. When a person is look like preoccupied body or preoccupied weight, means when a person is overweight and look like a fat person, that is a symptom of bulimia. And living in fear of gaining weight. When a person is living, there is a fear for weight gain. Next is repeated episodes of eating abnormally large amounts of food in one sitting. When a person is taking food more than necessity in one sitting, then that is also a symptom of bulimia disease or signs of a bulimia disease. Feeling a loss of control during being like you can't stop eating or can't control what you eat. When a person is not controlling what she will eat or he will eat and what is necessary for a person, what are the necessary requirements for a person and what are the nutrients is need, the person is not known about that nutrients or that nutrition, and she can't stop eating and can control what he will eat or she will eat, then that is also a signs or symptoms of bulimia disease. And next is dental problems. And sometimes some persons have dental problems and there is discoloring of teeth and dis-shape of teeth, that is also sign and symptom of a bulimia disease patient. Next is sore throat. Some persons have sore throat problem and this is also a symptom of bulimia disease. And next is forcing yourself to vomit or exercising too much to keep from gaining weight after weaning. Sometimes some persons are taking more food and overnutrition, and after taking of more food, after taking of over diet, the person is trying to exercise and also trying to for vomiting, and so that this is also a symptom or sign of a bulimia patient. Sometimes the persons are taking more food and they try to do this type of activities to avoid the overnutrition. But this is not perfect or this is not right for a person. Using laxatives, diuretics and enemas after eating when they are not needed. And sometimes some persons are taking that type of food and when that are not needed for a person. Fasting, restricting calories or avoiding certain foods between meals. And some times some persons are like to stay in fasting and restricting calories and more fat foods and avoiding certain foods from which they can get fat and they can get more calories. That is also a symptom of a bulimia disease patient. And next is using dietary supplements or herbal products excessively for weight loss. Sometimes some persons are using some supplements which is dietary supplements and also using some herbal products through which they can lose their weight. And sometimes some persons are using Herbalife and different products for weight loss. And this is also a symptom of bulimia patient. Because bulimia patient have eating disorder. They can't control their food. They can't avoid some foods. But they want to maintain their weight. They want to lose their weight. At that time, they are taking that type of supplements which are related with dietary supplements through which they can control their weight. That is also shine a symptom of a bulimia disease patient. Next is irregular periods and dizziness or fainting. And some women has irregular menstrual periods and they are sometimes they are being faint and dizziness. That is also a sign or symptom of bulimia patient. Feeling cold all the time and sleep problems. Some persons are feeling cold in all time and they have problems with sleep. They want to sleep but they didn't get proper sleep. So that is also a symptom of this disease. Next is causes of bulimia disease. Many factors could play a role in the development of eating disorders, including genetics, biology, emotional health, societal expectations, and other issues. There is different causes of bulimia disease and which is related with eating disorder, because eating disorder can play a vital role, an important role for development of a human being, for growth of a human being. And next is risk factors of bulimia disease, and sometimes causes are also known as risk factors. When persons are getting problem or when persons are facing problem due to some reasons, these are known as risk factors. Girls and women are more likely to have bulimia than boys and men are. Bulimia often begins in the late teens or early adulthood. Girls and women are more facing bulimia disease than boys or than men person, and this occurs at the time of teenage period or adulthood period. And next is factors that increase your risk of bulimia may include, and also some other risk factors which include biology. People with first degree relatives, means siblings, parents or children with an eating disorder may be more likely to develop an eating disorder, suggesting a possible genetic link. Being overweight as a child or teen may increase the risk. Sometimes biology is also a risk factor of bulimia disease. And in some genetic sector and in some family, due to some genetic problems, some children are getting fat and getting overweight, and which is depends upon siblings, parents and other family members. And due to biological problem also, sometimes some children are getting overweight and are getting fat. Next is psychological and emotional issues. Psychological and emotional problems such as depression, anxiety disorders or substance use disorders are closely linked with eating disorders. People with bulimia may feel negatively about themselves. In some cases, traumatic events and environmental stress may be contributing factors. Psychological and emotional issues are also sometimes reason of bulimia. Sometimes some persons are getting emotional problems, some persons are psychological problems, and some are in depression or in distress or in frustration. At that time, some persons are facing the problem that is bulimia. And at the period of emotional problem or psychological problem, some are not taking food and some are not taking proper nutritious food, and some are taking specific foods, and due to that the persons are not getting proper nutrients and not getting all the nutrients. They can get some specific nutrients. For that the persons are facing the problem that is bulimia. Next is complications in bulimia disease. And the complications are, bulimia may cause numerous serious and even life-threatening complications. Possible complications include, bulimia has also numerous and serious complications, and which is also sometimes life-threatening, and it includes negative self-esteem and problems with relationships and social functioning. Sometimes some persons has negative self-esteem and also some persons has problems in personal relationship with some specific persons, and also this results in problems in social functioning. Next is dehydration, which can lead to major medical problems such as kidney failure. And dehydration is also a complication in bulimia disease, because in bulimia disease, persons are taking more food. The persons are taking over nutrition and intaking food more than the requirement of the food. At that time, the persons are facing the problem that is dehydration due to taking of more food. And in that time, they can lead the major problems which are related with dehydration. Next is heart problems such as an irregular heartbeat or heart failure. Sometimes in bulimia disease, some are suffering from heart problems, and such as the heart problems are irregular heartbeat or heart failure. Sometimes some persons have heart failure, means heart is not pumping perfectly, and the heartbeat sometimes is more faster and sometimes is more slow. So that these problems and these complications which are related with the bulimia disease. And next is severe tooth decay and gum disease, and some persons has complications in teeth and gum diseases also. Some persons teeth are disshape, means they have teeth in different shape. Sometimes some persons teeth are disshape and discolor due to overtaking of toothpaste and due to more fluoride in their water and then in their food. And at that time, some persons are facing bulimia disease. In bulimia disease, they have complications in teeth, and this is severe also. Absent or irregular periods in females, and one complication is only for female at the time of menopause and at the time of menstrual period, they have irregular menstrual period, and also some in some months there is absence of irregular periods. Then is digestive problems, and digestive problem is which is related with bulimia, and which is the complications due to bulimia disease. In digestive problems, the patients or the persons who are suffering from bulimia disease, they can digest properly their food because of overtaking of food, because of overnutrition. They can't digest at the perfect time, and this is also a complication for bulimia patients. Anxiety, depression, personality disorders, and bipolar disorder. And some persons has also anxiety problem, depression problem. In some cases, they are getting depressed, they are getting distressed, and also personality disorder. Those who are suffering from bulimia disease. Misuse of alcohol or drugs. And the persons who are misuse the alcohol and drugs and all other medications also, they are suffering from bulimia disease. Self-injury, suicidal thoughts or suicide. When a person is getting distressed or depression in some cases, and also for personal disorder also, they at that time the persons are like to getting suicide, or they are taking suicidal attempt when they are in depression, when they are in distress, when they are in frustration. They like to do that type of activities. They are taking suicidal attempts at that time. And due to psychological disorder, persons are taking that type of step. And this is also a complication in bulimia disease. Next is preventions of bulimia disease. When some persons are facing some diseases, they have to prevent or they have to cure that problem, so that there is necessity of prevention. Although there is no sure way to prevent bulimia, you can steer someone toward healthier behavior or professional treatment before the situation worsens. Here is how you can help. And we have to prevent from bulimia disease, and you can steer someone toward healthier, and we have to change behavior and professional treatment for providing preventions or for providing precautions for the bulimia patient. And here we will discuss on some preventions which can help you from cure the bulimia disease. Foster and reinforce a healthy body image in your children, no matter what their size or shape. Help them build confidence in ways other than their appearance. Always foster or care your children to focus on their health, to focus on their activity, on their behavior. Don't focus on their appearance. When some children are focusing on their appearance, they can't take proper nutrients. They are avoiding some nutrients also which are necessary for a healthy person, for a human life. एंड फॉर दैट रीजन सम पेरेंट्स हैव टू अवॉइड दिस टाइप ऑफ एक्टिविटीज टू फोकस ऑन देयर अपीयरेंस. दे हैव टू अवेयर, दे हैव टू इंटरेक्ट विद द चिल्ड्रेन टू फोकस ऑन देयर ओन इमेज एंड टू फोकस ऑन देयर हेल्दी लाइफ. हैव रेगुलर एंजॉयबल फैमिली मील्स एंड द पेरेंट्स हैव ड्यूटी टू अवेयर द चिल्ड्रेन एंड टू अवेयर द फैमिली मेंबर्स टू एंजॉय द फैमिली मील्स इन रेगुलर बेसिस. अवॉइड टॉकिंग अबाउट वेट एट होम, फोकस इंस्टेड ऑन हैविंग ए हेल्दी लाइफ स्टाइल. ऑलवेज अवॉइड टू टॉक अबाउट योर वेट इन योर होम एंड ऑलवेज फोकस ऑन योर हेल्दी लाइफ स्टाइल. हाउ यू कैन मेंटेन ए हेल्दी लाइफ, फोकस ऑन दैट पार्ट. Discourage dieting, especially when it involves unhealthy weight control behaviors, such as fasting, using weight loss supplements or laxatives, or self-induced vomiting. And discourage for diet, because in dieting, when we are maintaining improper diet, that has bad effects on your health. And we have to control our weight, but in a healthy manner. Don't follow any unhealthy manner and unhealthy weight control behaviors. And when you sometimes some people are like to stay in fasting, like to avoid food, like to avoid major meals which are necessary for maintain a healthy life, and due to that reason some persons are facing some other health issues. When some person are like to do that type of activity, or when some persons are following wrong way, means like some persons are following to do fasting or to maintaining dieting, and in dieting also, diet also affects our health factors, because we have to maintain proper diet. We have to take all the nutrients which are necessary and necessary quantity for our health. We have to take that nutrients. Don't take some nutrients in over, and don't take some nutrients in lower quantity. We have to take all the nutrients in perfect quantity. When we are maintaining diet, then we have to maintain proper diet. But sometimes some persons are maintaining diet, but that was improper. Due to that reason, some persons are facing different or major health issues, and we can prevent the bulimia disease also through that way, through maintain proper balanced diet and through avoid fasting and through maintaining a healthy environment. Talk with your primary care provider. He or she may be in a good position to identify early indicators of an eating disorder and help prevent its development. And you can talk with your primary care provider, means you can talk with your primary care doctors. He or she can also know about how you can lose your weight, how you can maintain your balanced diet, and you can get some ideas from him or her about maintaining proper diet, about taking proper food or taking proper nutrients which are necessary or which are required for you. You can discuss with the primary doctor, because they have more knowledge on that. They have experience on that for providing proper nutrition chart or proper diet chart for the patients. And you can prevent the bulimia disease also through that factor. If you notice a relative or friend who seems to have food issues that could lead to or indicate an eating disorder, consider supportively talking to the person about these issues and ask how you can help. When you have noticed any relative or any friend of yours is taking or have food issues, and that also lead bulimia disease and other diseases also, when you are noticing eating disorder of a friend or of a relative, then you have to support her or you have to support him and talk about the proper nutrients and proper diet chart through which you can help them to maintain or to prevent the bulimia disease. In this class, we have discussed about what is bulimia disease, what are the causes or what are the reasons to which the bulimia disease occurred, and how we can prevent ह्यूमन लाइफ फ्रॉम द बुलिमिया डिजीज. थैंक यू, कीप वॉचिंग, हैव ए नाइस डे.